Backing down on a big campaign promise, Democratic presidential candidate Elizabeth Warren now says her government-run Medicare for All plan could be optional. Take a listen.
We're going to start by giving people a choice to opt in. Nobody has to vote on this until they've had a chance. And for 135 million people, it's going to be free. Now, they don't have to take it, but it'll be there for them.
Here now is Hadley Heath Manning, Independent Women's Forum Policy Director. What do you think about this little about face?
Well, at least she's backing off on a campaign promise before she's elected. A lot of politicians do it after the fact. But I would say it's pretty clear this is a politically motivated change. It's not a change of heart. It's not a change of philosophy. And I say that because Elizabeth Warren recognizes she's maybe gone too far to the left, even for many Democrat voters. And of course, we've known from the beginning, looking at polling, that public opinion on Medicare for All is malleable. And by that, I mean people change their minds when they find out more about it. And so she's backing off. I'm really now supporting what sounds like a public option in health insurance, which, as we all know, ultimately leads to one single option as a public option, runs private options out of the marketplace. But this is a key point. I think it represents a change in the Democratic primary where now they're starting to pivot towards the middle.
But I don't understand, you know, how do you know when these politicians are lying? Is it when they have the first position that's totally outrageous and you can't pay for it? Or is it when they come back to the center and try and convince people that they're not as scary as they seem? So when they get into office, maybe they are that scary and they do push for that thing, you know, or were they lying? In both cases, you can see how do you know when they're lying? I guess that's
right. Well,
yeah.
At least in Elizabeth Warren's case, Senator Warren's case, she's served in public office before. She's voted for different pieces of legislation. So we can look at her record, which I really think speaks more loudly than words. Sometimes you have people running for president or other public offices who've never held public office before. And in that case, you just have to take their campaign statements for what they are. I think in Elizabeth Warren's case, we know, you know, she's shown her cards on Medicare for All. We know that she supports that as the ultimate end. She'd rather see government in charge of health insurance.
Of everything. Yeah. Yeah, socialism on the rise. American voters having an increasingly positive view on socialism, although capitalism remains the favorite. This is according to a recent Fox News poll, which actually makes me laugh. Among the Democrats, positive views of socialism are up 8 points from February, standing at 51%, on par with their favorable views of capitalism. Hadley, you have an interesting theory to explain this. Tell us.
I do, and it comes down to definitions. It comes down to linguistics, how we use the word socialism. You know, a lot of younger people weren't around for the USSR. They don't think about socialism in terms of the textbook definition of a government-managed economy or, you know, when government owns the means of production. They think of socialism as basically a big welfare state. And we know this because they point to countries like the Nordic countries, which actually aren't socialist. They're market economies. But they have very robust welfare states that provide, you know, taxpayer-funded health care, taxpayer-funded education for everyone. And this is really where I think the crux of this debate is. We're better off debating those issues and debating those points rather than debating socialism versus capitalism, because unfortunately those words mean different things to different people.
They totally do. And you also made a great point that for younger people, it's about the idea, does it look like right now I could achieve the American dream, or does it look like that's impossible, too overwhelming, in which case I love the idea of the nanny state. It's sort of like, what does it look like out there in the long run for younger people? I thought that was a great point you made in your notes. Hadley, thank you.
Thanks, Melissa.